Good morning, Penn High School. I'm your PNN news anchor for today, Carson Jonathon.
And I'm Jonathon Mead. Welcome back to this edition of PNN. Today we start our show with a look at how the students who hosted the Riley Dance Marathon raised over $25,000 for Riley Children's Hospital.
A gloomy Indiana day did not stop students from celebrating their fundraising efforts in something much bigger than them.
So we're dancing FTK for the kids. The kids at Riley, we're fundraising for them. All of our money goes straight into Riley Hospital. It buys supplies, it buys new toys for the kids, whatever they need, the Ronald McDonald House. And so we're just dancing to celebrate them and what they've gone through. And they're sharing their stories. They're here to kind of tell us what Riley means to them. So we dance for them.
And it also is raising awareness so that people know what amazing organization it is, if they want to support it or if they need to reach out and go there. So it's really creating awareness and giving back to somewhere that's given so many people a second chance.
With performances from advanced dance class, pen poms, and a group dance taught throughout the day, everyone participated in showing support for Riley families.
It makes me pumped because you see young kids who are doing something to give back. And a lot of times kids of your generation are never thought of as doing that. So when I see that, it gives me a lot of hope for the future.
Families shared stories of health obstacles and log nights, as well as how Riley made their hard times comfortable. After 8 hours of dancing, Penn Dance Marathon came to a close with a major payout, donating just over $25,000. Reporting for PNN, I'm Abbie Hembrecht.
Thanks, Abbie, and congratulations to everyone who participated in the marathon.
A reminder that all seniors must fill out a transformation form for your plans after graduation. This form is mandatory to graduate and should take only a few minutes to complete. You can find it in your email or at Kingsman Nation.
The dodgeball tournament raised more than $2,000 for the American Cancer Society on Wednesday, April 11th. Congratulations to all the teams who participated in the tournament. It was the most competitive we've seen in years.
Now here's a look at your weekend's weather from PNN reporter Josh Engel.
Oh! Sorry, didn't see you there. Good afternoon, Penn. I'm Josh Engel, bringing you the weather all the way from the PNN studio. After our extended break, we are back into the swing of things with this edition of the weekend weather. Be on the lookout because lately the degrees have been disastrous and all over the place. Well, enough dilly-dally, let's get down to it. Today, with a high of 56 degrees and a low of 37 degrees, we are expected to have a high chance of rain throughout the day and night. Saturday, there was a high of 48 degrees and a low of around 30 degrees with a mostly sunny day and a mostly clear night. Sunday, with a high of 57 degrees and a low of around 39 degrees, we are expected to get a sunny day and a clear night. Well, that's all for the weather for today, Penn. Since we're in spring, search for some surprising sun, even though the snow is staying for slightly longer than suspected. We will survive it and slide into sunshine and slip and slides. That's all for now, Penn. Catch you later. Now, back to the desk.
Thanks, Josh. With rising temperatures coming a rising drive to get out at school, the administration would like to remind all students to finish the school year strong and that you're almost done.
Penn Theater will be hosting Lines of Illyria in the Studio Theater. The show will be held on Thursday, April 27th and Friday, April 27th at 6:30 p.m. and Saturday, April 28th at 2 p.m. Tickets are $5 at the door and online. Go to Kingsman Nation for the online ticket tracker link.
The summer weight room hours has been set for Penn athletes. On Monday, June 11th, the weight room will be open. You can go through door G. Normal weight room standards apply to any athlete who goes through the Penn Athletic Performance Program. Check with your individual coaches for more information.
Speaking of athletics and athletes, here's a look at the recent successes and the upcoming events in the world on Penn Athletics.
What's up, Penn High School? I'm Zach Comanine, here to take a quick look at this week's updates on Penn Sports. Now let's dive in. Tuesday, April 23rd was a busy day for spring sports teams. Softball had a home game against South Bend Clay. Penn won the game, ending with a score being 7-0. Anna Gustafson fires a two-hitter, striking out 9 and only walking 1, and drives in 2 runs. Jesse Buckey had 2 hits, drove 2 in, and had a triple. Mackenzie Griman also had a triple. Brenna Brown as well had a double. Baseball had an away game against South Bend Clay. Penn won, allowing Clay to get no points while they were able to get 13. Cameron Sinski and Lucas Konopinski combined for a one-hit shutout. Ryan Lynch had two hits, had two runs, and a double. Peyton Kerr and Marshall Ferner also got two hits. Their next game is Thursday, April 26th against St. Joe. Boys lacrosse has recently fallen upon a cold stretch, standing at 5-3, against a hard loss to rival St. Joe Wednesday, April 25th. After the boys had traveled to Father Bly Field for an under-the-lights game, the boys went down early 2-0 in the first quarter. At the end of the half, it was 5-2 in favor of the Indians. Jackson Lambert had a stellar game with four goals. Senior goalie Connor Fisher also had a solid performance with stops from all over the field, including multiple on-the-doorstep saves. Kingsman Lacrosse picks up again next week. Visit our website, pnn.phmschools.org, for more information as we learn more. Here's your chance to chase your volleyball dreams on May 1st, 8th, and 15th in the main arena. Co-ed volleyball intramurals will be held 3:30 to 5. You can choose your team before you get there or just show up and pick a team and play. Make sure you have your IDs. All athletes that are in Coach Kate's weight class that wish to lift over the summer, the hours are set for this year's summer weight room. Monday or Wednesday, 8 to 9, 9 to 10, 11 to 10, or 1 to 2. Tuesday or Thursday, 9 to 10, or 10 to 11. All right, Penn, that's all I have for you today. I'm Zach Comening. Have a safe weekend, and I'll see you next time.
Thanks, Zach. There'll be more sports events through the weekend. Be sure to tune in next week for another sports update with Zach.
That looks like that's the end of our show, Penn. Be sure to follow us on our social media at Penn News Network.
Have a great day, and we will see you next time.